know if y'all can see that, but what it is we have cottonwood trees here, and this time of the year is whenever the cotton flies off of it, and it just covers, well, it don't really cover the ground, but it comes in, like, when the wind picks up, it'll blow and blow. You might can see some of it now. It was real, real heavy a while ago, right before I come out, right when I was coming out to go to my garden. So pretty. Especially on, like, a cloudy day. It looks like it's snowing on a cloudy day. My garden is looking so pretty this morning. Y'all can see the rows where I've tilled them. And then I tilled in between my arches just to till the grass up. It hadn't grown high, but it was starting to grow. My roses have bloomed. This one's actually faded. It's a real pretty yeller. And this one's just now blooming. So beautiful. And then that sweet little baby there. Oh, it smells so sweet. And then my hydrangea bushes, a bush rose, is blooming. I can't remember if I told y'all the story, but my grandma Betty Mae and my great-grandma Sadie both had, we called them blue snowball bushes, but they were big old blue hydrangea bushes. I got to get them planted. And then my strawberries are doing great. And the ones in here are actually producing fruit. And something looks like it ate that leaf. And then over here, on this side of things, there's a little bitty strawberry on that one. Some on this one. Some on this one. And that's gonna have some too. They're so sweet. Okay, so I'm out here in my garden. And a couple of days ago, I got my squash planted. This whole row here, well, it's about a third of this row is squash planted. And then the rest of the row is going to be bush beans. I got most of the bush beans planted. I'm going to finish planting the rest today. And then this row here, all the way down is taters, different kind of taters. And then this row, the little short row, is also about half the way down, more taters. And then the rest of the way is onions. And then the one beside of it, the little short row down yonder, beside the tall grass that I've got to mow, that's also onions. And then I also got wild mullein plants growing up in my garden, which I look forward to every year. Because mullein is a wonderful herb. It is a wonderful expectorant. It is great for the lungs. It is great for people with COPD or asthma, or any kind of like bronchitis sickness and junk. It is wonderful for helping you breathe better. That is true. And I have given it to very many people. Well, not very many, but well, actually a great handful of probably about 5 or 6 folks I've helped with mullein. And they are doing wonderful. And that's because Yahweh created that herb, and Yahweh puts his healing powers in that herb. I always pull all over my tinctures and things that I give folks. And it always helps folks. So I'm thankful for that. So my mullein, there's 2 more plants over yonder by my mater's cattle panels too, that I'm going to just let grow. And it grows wonderful here in my garden. So I'm going to till between these rows here to keep the grass down and everything. But I'm going to mark my rows so I know for sure, you know, where everything is. Of course, I'll know when it pops up, and I'll have documentation like this video. But I want to keep everything else down and out of my garden while I'm doing that until I can get some mulch So that's my other onion row right over here. And then over here, this is my squash row. And I'm fixing to plant now my arches, and I'm going to plant on the outside of them. And I have some wild, and I say wild because they're volunteers that came up on their own. I believe this is cantaloupe. I'm fixing to look closer to see. And I have cantaloupe seeds, but because these are volunteers, I'm going to thin these out and plant these instead of my little seeds I have. Because they're ready. They're wanting to grow. Hello, Yahuwah. I love it whenever little plants volunteer. Okay, am I stepping in my row? No, I'm not. I always get freaked out. Am I stepping in my row? Now, I also had an idea. Everything's going to grow over my cattle panels, and they're going to hang down whenever it gets to that point. If I wanted to, I could to make a middle row that would go all the way down through my trellis of something that would be short and wouldn't take up a lot of room. That's an option I have. But I have so much room now over here. I've got to get this poison hemlock that decided to grow in my garden this year out of here. It just came up. I didn't have this problem none last year. Or the year before that. And now it has blown over here, seeded or whatever. And I need to get it out of my garden. So anyway, I've got all this space here now that I've got cattle panels. And I'm going to take advantage of that. I'm going to put my peas down yonder and my carrots. And you know, peas and carrots, they go together. So that's going to be the plan on that. So peas and carrots down yonder. And my corn, I always plant either painted mountain Indian corn or Cherokee glass corn, which my Cherokee glass corn just grows so big and beautiful and wonderful. I'll probably till this up here and plant my corn here in this one big block because corn grows best planted in blocks. So I'll probably plant my corn here, and I'm going to mow all this tall grass you see and refix my fence to make it look straight. So my corn will probably be here. Peas and carrots down there, and then I still have all this room. So, all this room to grow more things. Halal Yahuwah. Alright, I'm going to get busy planting my cucumbers. And then, I think it's going to be cucumbers, cantaloupe, gourds, watermelons, pumpkins, and my greasy beans. I've got some greasy beans, North Carolina's favorite. So anyway, I'm going to plant them down yonder. Correction. I just checked these out and these are actually cucumbers. Well, my cucumbers were further over. They were actually over right here where my cattle panels, the back ones are. Not right here, but way back yonder is where they were last year. And I'm pretty sure I had cantaloupe here this year. So, it's like, I don't know. So what I might do is I might just pull these up and plant them somewhere else. And see what I get. To see if they're cucumbers or cantaloupes. I can't remember, to be completely honest. Because they look very similar to both of them whenever they're that little. So I'll do some looking into that because I don't want to waste those sweet little babies. I just don't. When I see a volunteer plant, it's so hard for me to till over it. I mean, I really have a problem just tilling over volunteer plants. To me, it's a waste and I'm killing them. And I just don't feel like I should do that. So I should actually find a home for these. Because I'm growing certain cucumbers and I know I would probably love these. So if they are cucumbers or cantaloupe, I'm not sure which, I'm still going to probably dig them up in one big scoop and move them and maybe just plant them back here on the ground and get all that poison hemlock out of the way first. All right, I got them planted. I got my arches all planted. Hello, Yahuwah. It's hot today. And I got the rest of my rows watered. I mean, cause everything's underground and ain't gonna burn nothing. And I really needed to get the things watered. So everything's put in the ground. Well, not everything. My arches are planted, my taters and onions and squash and bush beans. And of course, pole beans are planted, my cucumbers, cantaloupes, watermelons, gourds, pumpkins are planted. Now I got to plant my peas and my carrots and a few other things over yonder when I till that. And of course the corn. And then I got the backyard garden, which is going to be the feed for the chickens. This is going to be some einkorn wheat, some dent corn, and some black oil sunflower seeds. So that's going to be another adventure. But yep, got it watered. And I am pretty much done for the day. Today's preparation day, Halal Yahuwah. Getting ready for our Shabbat to roll in at sunset, and it'll be over with tomorrow night at sunset. Or not tomorrow night, but right at tomorrow night. So I've got to go and get some more cooking done, get cleaning done. So when it comes that time, we can just settle in, read scripture, and rest. And I look so forward to that. I do. A day of rest is what we need, and Yahuwah gives it to us. Nobody much takes advantage of that. I won't say takes advantage of it. Nobody much obeys that command, you know. And it's not just any day you choose for it to be either. You have to study the scriptures and find the closest to his calendar that you can possibly get your hands on, so you know that you're right about at the same time that you should be bringing in his Shabbat. All right, here comes the cottonwood tree. Bringing its beautiful little cotton sprouts everywhere. And with that, I will tell y'all, have a fine day. Read your scriptures and grow something. Shalom from Hilltop Hall, y'all. Halal Yahuwah.